morning and welcome to another session of Q-Train. In today's session, we want to do a basic overview of the student growth spreadsheet. Okay, let's get started. When you first open the spreadsheet, the screen will look something like this. If you notice on the bottom, there are four tabs. There's a star monitor tab, a discipline hot list tab, a attendance hot list tab, and a my students tab. The bulk of our work will be in the my students tab, but we're going to get started with our overview using our star monitor tab. The purpose of this workspace is to provide a way to track the progress of a student that has been taking star assessments. First, let's look at our student Lexile score this row. Okay, let's say the child took their initial star assessment in reading and scored a 650, a 650 Lexile score in reading. Okay, I'm going to type that in. And then let's say on their second assessment, they scored a 675. Now, if you notice, it automatically tracks the growth. There's a 25-point gain. And I could do this throughout the year. And you notice it will give me, and it will always base the growth based on the original assessment score from the first assessment. Okay, the same thing is true for our grade equivalent in math. Let's say the child started and tested on a fifth grade third month. That's what 5.3 actually means, fifth grade third month. And let's say on the second assessment, they scored a sixth grade, first month. Well, we know that there has been an 8-month gain. Okay, so this in essence is how we would track and monitor the growth of a student through star assessments. Now, please be advised, star assessments has a variety of documents or reports that will do that for you with greater detail. But this is just something you can do or use if you choose to. We also have the discipline hot list. This is where we would track the discipline attendance of our students who have missed some days. We want to make sure that if a child is constantly in in-school suspension or out-of-school suspension, we know that they're not learning. So it would behoove us to monitor that. Let's say I scored three days of in-school suspension and 2 days of out-of-school suspension. It tells me my total number of suspension days. Now, in a another video cast, what we're going to do is learn how to go into Infinite Campus and pull up a child's attendance for the year so we can make a distinction between how many days that the child missed of class for out-of-school suspension, in-school suspension, and just normal absences. Okay, next, our next tab is our attendance hot list tab. It works similarly to our discipline hot list, but this spreadsheet, it combines discipline and traditional absences. Okay, so if I had 3 days of in-school suspension and 1 day of out-of-school suspension, that gives me 4 days of discipline days, but then I also missed 3 additional just days for I was sick. So now I know that I have a total of 7 days. It must be understood that the state of Georgia only recognizes any day, out of school, absence, unexcused, absent, excused. It doesn't make a distinction of why the child was out. If the child was missing class or missing a school, well, it counts as an attendance day. Okay, so in essence, this is the purpose of this sheet, which is to track our attendance days. And finally, we have our my students spreadsheet, which is where I'm going to monitor student growth in each of the units that I will be assessing. Okay, this pretty much ends our overview. In our next session, we will talk about how to actually extract information from SLDS and paste it in our spreadsheet so we can begin the process of monitoring student growth. Thanks a lot. I hope you enjoy. Bye-bye.